I just said to you that there's nothing I could do with it at this point. The only other option would be to bring it to the council.
And you had your secretary to put me on the agenda. You told her to put me on the agenda.
Okay, all right.
But I don't see you.
Okay, well, why don't you come and very briefly tell the council, because we've reached a point where there's nothing that we can do administratively at this point. Can't do anything further.
Okay, so roughly, I guess about a year ago in May when we came out and we had the module unit on the municipality. So as we was out there, we had a visitor from Al Howard from UBT, and he says, "Hey, can you guys make manhole covers?" I said, "Yeah, we think we can." So we went and we did a prototype. We came back and we had the prototype, and I'm sure you guys probably remember the demonstration that we did. And from there, Roland Vaughn and myself, we said, we talked to city manager at that time, Mr. Smith, and we talked to Al, we talked to Mr. Long. And so we talked about making the manhole covers for Tuskegee and UBT. So from that prototype, we went into production and testing and so forth to meet the requirements. So it took us about a year. Okay, we had a purchase order at that point for 100 units, minimum of 100, in order for us to go in and spend our money to develop.
So you have it from which body?
City.
From the city of Tuskegee?
Yes, sir. I have it here in the city. So basically, after going through all the testing, when we come to deliver, and I find out that the city manager is not in the office or Mr. Parker is. So at that point, I'm stuck with 100 units, and nobody seems to have an answer as to what I'm supposed to do with them. I have a purchase order that I actually made from.
Okay. Now, the purchase order is from the city manager at that time?
Yes, sir.
Not from the mayor?
No, sir.
Okay. From the city manager at that time?
Yes, sir.
Well, now, you know Mr. Howard is on UBT side.
We made 100 for UBT and 100 for the city.
For both?
Yes, sir. Okay. UBT has taken 10 right now, and they were saying that we're going to be able to supply them as they need the rest. But we made 100 for them also.
Well, the only thing that I can say at this point is, we are coming up to the budget time. Now, you make manhole covers for the city as used for our storm drain as well, right?
You guys have a
storm drain.
You guys have yours made out of metal. Ours is made out of materials, not metal. So you don't have to have the theft, as well as you can see how light they are. So it kind of helps the individual when they take them in and out, and you don't have to put the stress on their back. But what we have done...
How much does one of those cost?
The set costs
$344. $300?
$344 for the complete set. That's locked in. So you're currently spending $351 a set. So basically, what we have done, we have eliminated, hopefully, the set in it because there's no value. It's a 25-ton rating, national rating. Ours is 27 tons. So we actually gave more for less. But I have a purchase order that I worked from, or I wouldn't did. So I've invested our money, time and research for the units.
Okay, well, let me just say this. As I said, we have a different city manager now. The only thing that I can suggest that you do is get with him. We're coming up to the budget period now. And of course, he can tell you what he's proposing in the budget for man hold covers. All I can say is, if you have, it did come from me. It's regrettable that you invested resources and now we're not in a position to acquire them. But that's the fact of the matter. We have a challenge now, so let's see what can be done. I don't have an answer for you. The city manager will, I'm sure, meet with you and see what can. Probably has already met with you.
We have had a brief encounter. We have not addressed the issue.
Okay.
But
all right.
I have a legal binding purchase order that was signed by the city manager, or he wouldn't have went into production.
Okay. Well, we understand that, but let me just say this. Even though you have a signed purchase order, it was not necessarily authorized by this council. We'll deal with it, but I just want you to know that that would have to be our position. We want to be fair. And I like the idea about these items being, because I know we've been losing them because they stole them for the metal. This one may cut down on.
You currently have about 70 missing right now on your side.
Yeah, okay, well, get with the city manager. What I'm saying to you now and the council is, we can say to you, Mr. City Manager, he says that you all have had brief meetings. Would you please have another meeting with him and go through all the details? Because we're coming up with budget time now. Because we may decide that this is the route we want to go in the future, especially since these manholes are durable. Because I remember the test said they're just as good and probably cost less than these old metal ones.
Absolutely.
And people are stealing the metal ones because, and if we've got 70, what the world? We got 70 manholes that are open?
Yes, sir, on this side.
Well, don't tell anybody. Already. You all be careful driving.
I said we need to just move on to another subject. We can handle this administratively. You know, obviously this was something that we didn't know about this purchase order at all. You know, we purchased that law, we're talking $34,000. You know, that might be something we need to address internally, how that was done. But I think we need to move on right now.
Okay, so please get with our city manager. Let's take another look at it. Okay? But because of legal issues, I think we better leave this way it is right now. Okay? Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you so much. Now, we're open now for any other comments from any other person who'd like to make comments during the citizens' communications. Citizens' communications. Are you coming, ma'am?
Yes. Good evening, everyone. My name's Lenore Good. I'm going to get here a little bit late because I was running around doing stuff, working with the Census Bureau. Y'all were discussing the condemnation of the square, and I was doing some research. And I don't know if everybody's aware of the facts, but I have some of these. I have some copies I was going to have printed off. The sale of Alabama, are y'all aware of the sale of Alabama has the Confederate flag on the seat? That Georgia removed the Confederate flag off of their state flag now, but yet Mississippi still retained it, still has the Confederate flag incorporated in that. And I just came to say this, and that is that if we're going to condemn the square, we might as well take it all the way to the State House and figure where we're at, because we might be biting off more than we can chew. And the other fact is that who's going to pay for it? Okay, that's the bottom line. Are the taxpayers going to pay for it? And that's our again, all of that needs to be considered as well. So out of all fairness, and that's normally what I try to do, is be fair, look at the big picture, and do all the research. But think about that. Google that. It's very interesting. There's a lot of work to do in these southern states. And so just, you know, keep that in mind.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Anyone else? Any other questions, comments? Thank you so much. Okay, being none, we will proceed now to item 8, Mayor's Communications, City Council Work Session. Are there any other items that come out of the City Council's from the work session? Any other questions that council members may have, or anything you want to call to the attention of the city manager? Okay. Being none, we'll go to authorization to submit an application for ARC funding. In meeting with them, I indicated to SCAD that we were interested in trying to get some of this year-end money that may be available. And before October 1st, we would be interested in submitting a proposal to try to get funding to do something about Bibb Street. And she indicated that if we did it on the second council meeting, rather than the night, that would give us time to have a budget pulled together and to know exactly what the matching requirement is. But I just wanted to get some feel from the council tonight if you want us to move forward with trying to get an application pulled together. And at our second council meeting, we should have that application nailed down in terms of the cost. We tried to get, you remember, Bibb Street covered once before in a regular community block grant application, but it did not, it was not approved. We may be able to get it done through ARC, so there's a good chance we can get it done. I had the assistant director of ADECA here last weekend. She had a chance to ride that street, and it is in very bad shape, as well as a number of other streets across the city, the Brown Street community, and a number of other streets across the city that we ultimately need to address. So, but what is the consensus? Shall we move forward with asking the manager to go ahead and prepare the application?
Mr. Mayor?
Yes.
Yes, you know, I'm pretty anxious to talk on the subject because we have had Bibb Street as that community on our list for a number of years. And I've asked city managers to look into giving them some relief, even if we just scrape it down until we can find funding. I'd like to commend you for even speaking up for that project because, like other communities in the city, but I think that's at the top, or probably one of the top of the list in District 3. The Bibb Street corridor, which is a historical street in the city of Tuskegee, is absolutely demolished. So thank you very much for the funding, and I agree that we should proceed.
I would agree with Councilwoman Moon. We have several streets in the city that are in pretty bad shape. It's no favoritism to Bibb Street, but as you all know, that street is well traveled. People, a lot of people use that to cut through on a daily basis, and the wear and tear on the street really shows it. So as far as a priority, I think that should be pretty high on the list, even, you know, ahead of a lot more residential streets. But certainly I would agree with Councilwoman Moon. We share that street in our districts, and any support we can get or any action we can take to smooth out that road, I think, will definitely be a big benefit and something that the citizens would appreciate. So thank you, Indiana Mayor Ford, for supporting that as well.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Not to mention the detour now that's coming through. It's even more congested and deteriorating if you can get it any worse than it is now.
Right.
I was talking to the citizens there, and that the detour coming through Bibb Street is just like a traffic jam.
because they're working on the street for the campus, which incidentally, they're getting that half of it. One side is done. We're hoping they could get it done before the first game, but they're going to get back on it and get it done. So this is, you got the drill.
We got marching orders.
Okay, good. All right. And so we'll have something in writing for our next council meeting. Okay? The next item is, okay, condemnation of Commodore Square. Let me just very briefly read the benefit of the public on this square business. And I'm glad to see the dialogue and all of this, but essentially, I wrote to Mrs. Lindley Edwards, the president of the Alabama Division of the Alabama Daughters of the Confederacy. I said, "Dear Mrs. Edwards, City of Tuskegee has initiated plans to acquire the city square for public purposes. It has been called to my attention that in 1956, the Daughters made a portion of the square available for a public purpose. Parking, public access, sidewalk, etc., for the amount of $1. Therefore, I would like to propose that for $1, the Daughters would deed to the City of Tuskegee the town square for public purpose again. The City of Tuskegee would acquire a professional company to lift the Confederate statue and move into another location within the city limits. The city's only motive is to acquire the square for public purpose. You indicated that you plan to come to Tuskegee to meet with the members of the Tuskegee chapter of the Daughters of the Confederacy. I would be honored to meet with you in a calm, courteous